Hi guys, I'm Steph. Thank you so much for checking out my channel. So for me, 2019 is all about the year I want to pare down my collection. I'm not going for like a minimal route. I just want to have less products at the end of the year than I do at the beginning of the year. So pretty much I just want to use more than I purchase. I did a whole video talking about kind of like my makeup goals for 2019, including like I talked about low buy, no buy. I talked about my panning goals on a bigger scale and that type of thing. So I'll link that video down below in case you're interested. But today I'm going to be sharing with you my winter project pan. So I'm planning on doing seasonal project pans as well as a year-long project pan. So the video introducing my year-long project pan will be coming out next. So if you're interested in that, then make sure you subscribe. Today I'm going to be talking about the products I want to finish by April 1st. So I know we're like already a bit into January, and I picked these products out like January 1st and have been working on them, but I didn't make the video and I haven't been tracking my progress. So this is kind of the intro video, even though I really have been getting some use out of these products, but I wanted to share them with you, and my goal is still to get these products done or reach my goals by April 1st so that I can continue doing the seasonal projects. So in here I actually have two items that are carryover from my finished 18 in 2018. If you're interested in that, I'll link the playlist down below. The first is the NYX Angel Veil Primer. When I finished up that project at the end of December, I was here. And now I am right here. So I just have a little bit left to finish off. I kind of thought about like not including it in a project, but I've been working so hard on it and I really wanted to show you my progress. And I kind of worried if I put something else in this project, a different primer, then I would stop focusing on this completely, and I really want to get this moved out. So the second product that is a rollover from my finish 18 in 2018 is this Sephora lipstick. And this is how much I have left. I'm going to show you against the marking of where I was at the end of last year so we can see the little bit of progress I have made. So this is where I am right now. It's kind of easier when the product isn't there. I'm at this bottom line and I was at the middle line last time. I am going to be getting a whole new paper to mark everything on, but I just wanted to show you the little bit of progress I have made in January. Now these eight products are products that have never been in projects before. So the first is my favorite foundation. This is the number 7 Stay Perfect Foundation, and I'm actually all the way down here. I have been working on it since the beginning of the month, and it might be surprising to put a foundation with so little in a project at this point, but it's one of my favorite foundations, and since I noticed I was so close to finishing it, I have not used it in like the last 2 weeks. So I really want to get myself to finish it, and I know even though it's just this little amount left, if I want to scrape down the sides, I think it's going to last me longer than I think, and I want to make sure I actually get this out even though I love it. Next is a stick concealer that actually matches that foundation. This is the number 7, what's it called? Match Made Concealer in Calico. And I totally did not mention what this foundation is called. It's the Stay Perfect Foundation. Anyways, unfortunately, I did not mark this at the beginning of the year. I have been using it a lot and I am right here. I'm definitely going to be marking it. This is something I use to cover up, to get a bit more coverage before I go in with foundation. Or if I am quick, I'll just cover up my blemishes with this and blend it out type of thing. So definitely a product I'm getting a lot of use out of. And the last product where my goal is to actually finish it up is this lip gloss by Soap & Glory. It is their Sexy Mother Pucker lip gloss. And I am right here. So this is probably the oldest lip gloss in my collection. I have gotten some fair use out of it. So I just really want to go ahead and finish it off. I'm about halfway there. So hopefully I can get that done in the next 2 months. So for these last 5 items, my goal is just to hit pan on them, and a lot of them have not had a lot of use before this project, so we'll kind of see how it goes. The first is a pressed powder, and this is the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte. I'm in the shade, whatever the lightest shade is, 100 Porcelain, and just to kind of give you guys a close-up of where I am, there's not really any visible dents, even though I have been using this pretty much every day. I like that it has a kind of bottom compartment to it, with like a mirror and a sponge so I can touch up throughout the day. So I try to bring it with me, but I don't really do a lot of touching up, but in case I want it, it's there. Next one that I'm trying to hit pan on is this Hoola Benefit Bronzer. It's just a little mini, but I have been using it all month and I haven't yet to see any dip or anything. So I feel like this might be a bit ambitious. If you've panned a Hoola bronzer before, can you let me know, does it take a while to hit pan? And oh, another thing I'm kind of having issues with this is that it is a mini, so it's a very small. Let me show you my bronzer brush. So this is the brush I use for bronzer, kind of out of shape right now. But like, this is it trying to fit in. It like, I don't know if you can tell, it like comes out over the sides. Anyways, yeah, that's kind of irritating. So I've thought about depotting it, but I don't really have anything to depot it to. So yeah, just thought I would share that little grievance with you. This one might be the most ambitious of all. I'm trying to hit pan in a blush, and I'm not sure if giving myself 3 months is really enough time to hit pan in a blush, if I should maybe be going for 6 months. But this is the Revolution Makeup Blush in Love. And this is where I am right now. I'm not sure if you can tell. There's not really a dip going on. It did say Revolution here, and I've kind of worn that away for the most part. I'm trying to kind of concentrate in the center. It's a very powdery formula, so at first I was like, oh, it'll be easy to hit pan because it's so powdery. But it is also so pigmented. So I'm not really sure how this is going to go. Just to give you guys a little swatch of this one, because it might not be a product as many people are familiar with. It's right here. I think it's so beautiful for the winter, but I'm just nervous that 3 months is not enough time to hit pan. So this is a challenge, and we'll see how it goes together. And then last, I am trying to hit pan in two eyeshadows. They're both from the I Heart Makeup Salted Caramel, and this was a dupe for the Too Faced Semi-Sweet Shots Bar palette, which I think they've discontinued, which I'm kind of disappointed in, because even though I have the dupe, I really did consider buying the Too Faced one, but that is no longer an option. So I'm trying to hit pan in two shades. This cream shade right here, which is delicious, and this kind of like warm tone, I use it as a transition shade called Sweet. I have to like look at the little insert. It's called Sweet. So this is delicious. This is Sweet. I have been using them every day that I've worn eyeshadow, but I have not worn eyeshadow every day. I'm not sure you can really see too much progress in it. I am kind of trying to focus my brush right here above this like pink shade and then focusing in the middle here. This one, I can like feel it. It has a bit of a dip. This one, I can see some use, but not too much. I am going to do close-up shots so it's easier to track progress. But I find those, it's kind of hard to tell in a picture like if progress is really being made. I find it difficult, at least in the pictures I take, to kind of show you the progress. But I will definitely be taking pictures. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I have not been wearing a lot of eyeshadow because when I'm in a rush and I need to like cut down some time in my routine, eyeshadow is like the first thing to get cut. So I either need to wake up earlier, get faster at applying my makeup, or like not use eyeshadow. So hopefully one of the first two happens. Hopefully I get up earlier, but probably not. So if you're interested in seeing how I get on with these products, then make sure you subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a great day or night wherever you are. Bye!